through the end, and then we will pick up looking at those closing moves. I definitely will accept and admit that these closing moves are difficult to convey on camera, but I will do my best. Had a request for some additional angles. I think that's a great idea. Provided, as I'm changing angles, don't try to practice it with me from different angles, because that will mess up your mirror neuron something crazy. So if you guys can just, jump at the bit, and if I've changed directions just for you to observe what's happening, not try to practice it in an opposite direction facing you, which will make it so much worse. So just hang tight, and we'll practice it facing the right way, but I want to show you things from other directions, provided you just watch those and not get it all twisted up in your head. Okay, so let's start it from the top. I know I did that a little faster than we've previously been doing it. I did that on purpose. That was not a mistake. Miss Durkin, no! I want to be able to show you the varying paces of this. There's been enough lessons of these online that you can go back to for super duper slow walkthrough paces. You can stop it and practice it on your own, which I highly encourage that you do. We as instructors, we kind of look around the room and go, oh, I think everyone's got it. And then we walk off and say, show me. People don't got it. So the way that you get that is, do not rely on myself or Senior Head Instructor Fig to constantly lead you through that sequence. Hopefully you're taking some time to not follow us, put us on pause, stop it, come back at another time, and see how much of this you can get through on your own. Even if you don't remember it, that's okay. It's the exercise of trying to get through it, which will help you get that the sequence down. So don't always try to copy us. Really push yourself to try to do it on your own. And that's also one of the reasons why I'm gonna change the pacing that we do to kind of flex those muscles a little bit, okay? I'm not trying to be mean. I'm actually trying to help your Tai Chi. Okay, the closing form. Let me just show you from the right direction. So I've got my last low strike. Remember from here, we talked about taking the attention from here and putting it here. So I've done my strike. Then I sink down thinking low end. I turn it over. I think lead with this end. And I'm going to lift up and turn my waist with this arm, leading with this edge of the stick. So that gives me that little hop so that I can take the step forward. I'll show you this from the front in just a second. And back. This move really is extremely difficult, if not impossible, to teach slowly. This is the turn. It's super hard. So the best way is to just kind of get the fundamentals of it and practice in socks or something. You know, this the spin. It'll make a lot more sense than trying to micromanage. Well, I take a foot and I do this. It'll be harder. I promise. All right. So that you can see it come at you, the closing form. I've done my last strike. Remember now, I'm not thinking here, I'm thinking here. and then I'm going to turn this over, and I'm still going to think about here. I'm going to, what am I going to do? I'm going to lead with this, push off with this foot to get the momentum to turn on this foot. It's a lot. Here, here. Push off here so that I can turn here. And then I step. Bring the arms together. This is where it switches sides. Then I step back with the left foot and right. So that's why I'm hoping you're not actually trying to practice along with me, because now it's flipped. Hopefully you see that. So without talking, show you again from this direction. Together. I'll go super slow and I'll stop in between the little pieces so that everyone can hopefully catch up with me. So where I'm coming from is I've done low, low. Everybody with me? So I've done my high, high, low, low, high, high, low, low. I'm going to turn, thinking of this, kneel down, prayer position. Okay, everyone here? My weight, I have weight on this foot, but most of my weight is on my front foot. I am going to turn this over. I am going to straighten my arm. I mean, not lock it out, but straighten it and come up at the same time. So I'm going to straighten and come up. While I do that, I'm going to push off of this front leg so that I can pivot on the back leg. And try it. And then step forward. With that left foot. And step up to even with the right foot. Stick goes out in front, grab it with both hands. Step back with the left foot, let the foot rotate down. Step to even with the right as the stick comes forward, makes a circle. And down. Okay? Let's try it again. I know this is complicated. So, down, turn the stick over, push off, open, and turn. It's really hard to do slow. Step, take that left foot, flute goes out in front, step back with the left, flute goes down, step back with the right, flute goes around, and back. Watch it. Watch it. Do it a couple different ways. So. Do it from the actual angle. Because the more committed you are to just doing it, just, I'm going to do it, I'm going to turn, the easier it will actually be to get around. The more, like I said, you guys who train with me, you know I have the world's most persnickety, high-dollar, surgically prepared knees kind of out there. and hesitating is what hurts my knees on this. If I just go, my knees don't bother me at all. So I will say that to you as well. It's the friction and stopping that makes it uncomfortable. So kind of just let it go. Like, don't overthink it. Don't like, just try it. Just try to play with it. And I'm also saying, remember that Tai Chi in Chinese, they talk about you play Tai Chi. You don't train Tai Chi or do Tai Chi, you play Tai Chi. And if it's a super complicated move, that attitude of playfulness will help you measurably. Okay, so let's just try it a few times on our own, I mean, with me. Don't stress about if you can do it or not. Just try to have fun with it. One other logistical thing I would say is that coming up is what takes my body weight a little bit off by coming up, it helps me. If you hear us talking about micro jumps, it's a little bit of that, but it's not a hop. It's just a turn. But the spin and the lifting up takes my body weight out of this foot enough that it can pivot. So those are the kind of the technical nuts and bolts of it, and the rest of it you just have to try it and not get hung up about it looking silly. Just go for it. Okay. So let's we've done our last high, make low, and down. Turn it over. Push off, turn, and go. Step with the left. Out with the right. Back with the left. Flute comes around at the right steps and back. I'm going to keep going. If you want to practice on the one you were just on, that's totally okay. All right. And down. Over. Turn. Go. Cool. I hesitated. Good job. Remember, expectation management, master's path, is about exposing you to more difficult concepts sooner. It's not about nailing it, right? So all of these seeds and practices that you're getting will have impact and benefit through all of your other forms. So try to manage that expectation of, I'm not getting it, I don't remember the sequence, I can't do that move. You will get it because you're seeing this so much sooner than you would necessarily in other, you know, in kind of regular class pacing. Okay? So good work, everyone. With that, we will bow out of master's path. Bow to each of you. See your head instructor. We'll see